Now I'm going to consider pipe coefficients, how we can do a pipe coefficient, when we can use the pipe coefficients, then the concept of pipe coefficients. These are the things I'm going to be discuss now. Yes. Now, this is called pipe coefficients. Pipe coefficient correlations is suitable for situation in which neither of two variables can be measured in terms of scores, but both the variables can be separated in terms of two categories. When both the variables are dichotomous, the same attributes, we can use pipe coefficient correlations. Here we can use the term, the pipe coefficients, I put as a wrong term. So pi represents this term. See here, this is a pi represents terms. I'm changing the terms now itself. So here the pipe coefficients, it's not a term. So pipe coefficient, this is a term. We have to use this term for pipe coefficients. Yes, now I'm coming back. But the condition, main condition to use the pi coefficients, it should be a natural dichotomy. But the tetrachoric correlation, we are using the artificial dichotomy. But in this case, we can use the natural dichotomy only. We can use the pi coefficients. See here once again, I'm going to highlight the different names of pi coefficients. The pi coefficients, some people may highlight as a Yule's pi, otherwise mean square contingency coefficients. Mean square contingency coefficient. There's a different names are there for pi coefficients. The pi coefficient is measured the association between the two binary variables. Two binary variable, but I already mentioned that it may be dichotomous, but in a natural dichotomous or in a genuine dichotomous or a true dichotomous. For example, living dead. So we are able to check the people whether they're living or dead. Only two classes. It's not a continuous. We are converting as a category, it basically is a nominal only two-fold classification like living, dead. Then black and white, black or white. Then success or failure. So we can be classified or pass or fail. Only the two classification may come. In this manner, we can adopt this kind of pi coefficients. But it may be contingency table like ABCD. So we already discussed. So this kind of contingency table like ABCD format. Now the four classification fourfold is there. From this condition, we can use the pi. So these are the condition. At least one variable in nominal variable. Other may be ordinal. That's not an issue. But both the variables in dichotomous variable. This is the condition we can use the pi coefficients. Both it should be a dichotomous. That we already know. Yeah. So one more additions of example I'm going to highlight now. The pi is a non-parametric, it's a non-parametric statistics. Even the previous one we discussed as a tetrachoric also a parametric, because once you take into consideration only the continuous scales only, we may use the parametric, but in these conditions, we are using only the categorical, four categorical classification only. Therefore, it damn sure it's a non-parametric statistics used for cross-tabulated table data where both the variables are dichotomous. So dichotomous also, it be a natural dichotomous. Some people are using natural dichotomous as a name, or true dichotomous, or a genuine dichotomous. A lot of names are there. So normally, dichotomous means that there will be two possible values of variables. Here I am giving the example. The variable addressing life has only two levels, like alive and not alive. It means that live or dead. So that is a two-fold classification or two classification. Suppose I am a public health department. I want to do some research. I have to take the proportions of newborn alive versus born dead. So I am taking is a newborn baby and old born baby. There's a two classification of baby. Newborn, old born. Then there is a two classification like alive and dead. So it means that I have two variable but two-fold classification in each. For that, I am using a pi coefficient as a statistics. Yeah, see here, this picture is giving the exact thing. Sometimes it may be same attributes like male-female. This also male-female. For example, male-female of different group, male-female of science group. So we have to go with the same. It may be or different maybe also comes there. There is no thumb rule for the same attributes like male, female, here also male, female. I'm selecting the one color to highlighting this one. See here. The first variable is a genuine dichotomous. The second variable is a genuine dichotomous. But it may be same attributes. Sometimes it will be different attribute also. But genuine represent true. I hope you understand. Genuine represent true dichotomous. It means that basically we classify only two classification only. It's not the continuous nature. Generally, we may take it's only the classification based or category based only, but in the two classifications. For example, male, female is a one group category. Then married, single. It means that married male students, one group. Married female students in another group. Single male, one group. Single female is another group. So there is a four category of divisions. The same like as a tetrachoric, but only the thing. This variable in the tetrachoric is a continuous nature, but the continuous we are converting as a categorical. It's nothing but it's like an artificial dichotomy and, in the case of tetrachoric. But it is a pike option, therefore this is called natural dichotomy, like male, female, married and single. This is called natural dichotomy. Now this is an example. For example, there is a yes or only the two classifications like yes or no. Yes or no. So the people may give only yes or no response. Only there is no median and all. Like male, female, alive, not alive. Male, female, yes or no. Then favorable, unfavorable. There are also favorable and unfavorable. Suppose if you are taking, for example, yes is a positive notes. Yes is a positive. Okay. No is a negative. Here also no is a negative. So in this case, I am taking the A always a positive for checking whether it's a positive or negative. I am taking B, see here, positive into negative, negative, negative into positive, negative, negative into negative, positive. Therefore, in this case, A and D are positive. The same thing, if AD value is greater than the BC, then it's called positive correlation. If you get it. But suppose I'm in the table, I put in the reverse order. I'm putting the reverse order. That's why I'm putting, instead of A, I'm putting B. For understanding purpose, see here, A, yes is a positive, no is a negative notes. I am taking yes is a positive, negative. So here positive, negative, negative, positive, 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 negative, 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 sorry, positive, sorry, yeah. Then negative plus, so minus into, sorry, minus into plus, minus. So in this case, minus. Therefore, I am putting the A, D here. So instead of B, C, because I am changing the order here. Therefore, we are also changing the order here. We can take it ASASS only. DSA, no, no only. So that is why I am making like this. The formula for pi coefficient, this is a formula. AD minus BC divided by root of A plus B into root of C plus D divided by into A plus C into B plus C. It's nothing but the addition. See here, this is an addition. A plus B addition, this one, A plus B. Here, A plus B may comes. This is the addition is called like row addition, column addition. This is called C plus D. This is called, I'm adding the row additions. If you go with the column, this additions like horizontal, this is called A plus C. This is called B plus C. Like that, we can go with the row addition and column additions. So we may get this one. So B plus D. We may get B plus D. So this way it may come there. So now if BC is greater than AD, then it's negative. These things we already know. Now I'm moving to the same thing which we discussed the previously also. The two finite variable, it's called as a positive associate. It means that AD are larger than BC, it may tell as a positive. If it's negative associate in the sense, it means AD are lesser than the BC. So, but in an actual dichotomy only, we are using the pi coefficients. Yes, now I'm directly mounting the sum. It's very simple sum, like tetrachoric. Calculate pi value. So here we have the two classification. Yes or no, one variable, then another variable, so yes or no. But here same attributes here. If you go with male and female also no problem. For example, male, yes, female, no. So here it means yes, yes. For example, I'm taking the two variable like, are you like technology? Then I'm going to ask the question, are you like statistics? So this is for how many people are telling yes in this technology, how many people are telling the no in the technology. The same way, how many people are yes, telling the research, they like yes, how many people are telling no. So in this case, I'm checking the yes of technology, those who are telling technology they like as a yes, how many people are telling yes in the research methodology also. That is a number. So it means that 50%, 50 students are telling yes in the case of technology, in the case of research also. So in this case of 80 represents, 80 people are highlighting technology yes, then 80 students are telling technology is a research is no. So this is way I'm put the classification, the table represent. I'm doing directly to this sum. So we have to find out the value of AD and BC. Therefore, I'm checking the AD and BC. AD 15 to 40, therefore 200. Then BC 18 to 90 is called 4,800. Therefore, what it means, whether it's a positive correlation or negative correlation, please kindly give the response here, the chat box. Is it a positive correlation or negative correlation in this example? So is it a positive or correlation? Yeah, very good. So Surya is correct because in this case, BC is greater than the AD. Therefore, it purely is a negative correlation. So it's negative correlation. Now I have to find out the A plus D, C plus D, A plus C, B plus D because we have to substitute the value in the formula. Therefore, A plus B is nothing but 50 plus 80, 130. Then C plus D is nothing but this one. So these two values additions. Next, A plus D, 50 plus 60, this column additions. Then B plus D, this and column additions. So 80 plus 40, then 120. So I found the entire value of A plus B, C plus D, A plus C, and B plus D. Then I'm going to apply the formula here. So this formula we know, the pi of AD minus BC. Therefore, AD value is 2000, then BC value is 4800. Then end down the denominator root of A plus B, 130. C plus D 100, A plus C 110, then B plus D 120. If you take either root, we may get that answer like this much is may come in. So once I solve this, the bracket value, I may get the value of pi is called minus 0.2137. Why I put even here it's a minus value is coming because the minus is coming because here we may get that BC value is high, so default it comes a minus value. Therefore, we can easily to check whether our things comes a negative correlation. So we may get the negative correlation, but the negative correlation value is 0.2137. It means that it's a moderate level. So we already know this classification of the general classification or the thumb rule of correlation. Like if the correlations value comes minus 0.3 to plus 0.3 is called little or no association, not that much of association, but it may be little association. So that's why I'm telling it's a little association between these two variables. Therefore, we can come for the conclusion that there is a little association between the two variables which we took here. So, but in a negative, we are easy to come for conclusion in this. Yeah. So now, just I'm going to be wind up with a final note. So we are discussing about the pi coefficients only. The pi coefficients, when we can use the pi coefficient in this sense, if both the variable, we need two variables. If both the variables dichotomous, but natural dichotomous only, we can use the pi. When we use the tetrachoric in the sense, we need two variables, but both the variables dichotomous, but artificial dichotomous. So you may confuse with pi and tetrachoric, both look like a same, but only the small difference between the two. If natural dichotomous, you can go with pi coefficient. If it artificial dichotomous, you can go with tetrachoric. The same thing, you may have the confusion biserial and point biserial. We need two variables. One variable, it should be an interval in the same for the biserial point biserial, that's called interval. The second variable, it should be a dichotomous, but the type of dichotomous only, the point biserial and biserial may change. If naturally dichotomous, you can go with point biserial. If it artificially dichotomous, we can go with biserial. So this is a condition we can use the point and biserial. But in the case of Spearman rank correlations, both the variables should be ordinal. In the case of Pearson product moment correlation, both the variables are continuous or interval nature. But we have the one more correlation that's called gamma correlations. Then we can use in the sense, one scale is a nominal, other scale is a ordinal. So we have the two variable, one is a nominal, other one is an ordinal. Like for example, I'm taking say male and female, other one is a ranking of the people. So other is height based ranking, any ranking based on other variable, then you can go with gamma coefficient of correlations. I hope you understand the pi coefficients. Just I'm going to summarize the pi coefficients. The pi coefficients used for measuring the correlation between the two variables when both are expressed in the form of genuine or natural dichotomous. The bi coefficients has the same relation with the tetrachordic correlation as point biserial has with biserial coefficient also. Normally, it can be checked against the Pearson uptrend from the same variable. It's most useful in item analysis when we want to know the item-to-item correlation for this we are using. I hope you understand the entire pi coefficient as well as the other correlation also. Thank you so much for your patient listening. Thank you so much. Bye. Jai Bharat.